Joining us now on the Volkswagen Dealers Expert Hotline is Celtics owner Wick Grosbeck. Joining us on the horn. Wick, how you doing? I hope all is well with you and your family.
Thank you. Same to you. We're doing fine here. We're in sequestration. It's been like 35 days, but who's counting? But we're okay, thanks. Although, you know, every call I make or touch base with people, it seems like people are, you know, out there. I mean, there's some serious situations. So heart goes out to them.
Okay, Wick, thanks again for joining us. Let's just get right to it. Are you under the assumption that the NBA will be resuming play at some point this year?
I'm hopeful, and we're on literally almost daily different committee calls and league-wide calls, and the tone or the substance of the meetings is always safety first, and that's not just a buzzword or a phrase. It's exactly how Adam and all the owners feel, is we got to make sure it's safe. So that's going to mean testing and everything else and safety precautions. But when it's safe, we're going to go ahead. I'm not predicting when, but the idea is to try to do something once safety is assured. It's not safe now, so there's been no decisions.
Are you optimistic?
I am optimistic.
Why?
Because I think we've got time. We don't have to play according to the original schedule. We would have been in the playoffs right now. We would have had home games last weekend, I think it was. And we've got the futures in front of us. I mean, I'm working with, not with testing, but with a vaccine program and also backing a drug trial at MGH out of the charitable foundation. And you know, I'm just optimistic in general as a person, but I'm optimistic that eventually we'll get to a place where it'll be safe to reopen society.
So Wick, we want to get to that drug trial here in a second as well, but with regard to the possibility or probability even of playing, one of the scenarios, the most popular scenario, involves Vegas. Is that, if and when it does happen, is that in all likelihood what it's going to be?
Well, it's a fair question. You know, as usual, it seems like whenever I come on, I'm like, well, the league won't let me speak about this or that or the other thing. The fact is that Adam has said we won't make any decisions under any circumstances until the next date would be May 1st. But it could be, who knows, June 1st or July 1st before a decision is made, either to go or no go. It has not been made now, and so it's not for me to speculate. I can imagine that we're more likely to come back. I mean, different cities in the country are affected differentially. They're different situations. And so if we're trying to come back as soon as we can, you'd probably put that into the balance of where we can play. But that decision hasn't been made, just to be honest. So don't know. I'm on the executive committee of the league, so when it's made, you know, I'll be in there pitching for it, but it hasn't been made yet.
Are there things you've ruled out? Have you ruled out playing games in Boston?
No, nothing's been ruled in or out. It's the honest truth. So if I knew more, I would have to say I know more, but I can't comment. But I don't know more. What I know is there's no decisions. There's a lot of talk, and we get briefings from medical experts. We had a leading sort of Nobel quality person on the other day briefing all 30 owners. And I mean, we're trying to dig in as deep as we can. We really care. We care not only about playing the games, but about the people whose livelihoods are affected. And it affects a lot of people positively if we can play these games safely.
So again, I'd ask you to speculate, but outside of your, you know, worldview as just an optimistic person, the actual facts and functionality and talks and momentum of the thing is still pointing towards you coming back at some point and playing NBA basketball.
But this is more based on, here's what I'm saying though, or what I'm trying to say is, it's more based on me reading about tests becoming, you know, is there going to be a lot of testing available that's definitive and reliable 4 weeks from now, 8 weeks from now, 12 weeks from now? Is antibody testing going to be good enough? Or does it turn out you need to have a quick test for if you actually have the virus in your bloodstream? And those are being developed as well. Quick virus tests are being developed, is my understanding. So maybe we say we got to wait for a quick virus test, not these antibodies. You know, a ton of people have the antibodies. They might not be immune. They still might be carriers. You know, so maybe antibodies aren't good enough. This is science now, which I don't know. I'm just reading in the paper. This is not basketball. It's science. And so if we say we've got to have a virus test, we have to be able to know if you have the virus or not, if that can be done in 5 minutes, then you can test everybody who wants to come to a game. You can test all the fans who want to come attend the game. I mean, in theory. So it really comes down to the science being, meaning that it's safe to play in some form or fashion, and then we'll play in that form or fashion.
So, Wick, with regard to the testing, one of the questions I have is how frequently would players need to be tested in order for it to work?
Well, these are the questions that we're asking ourselves on the call. So I'm right with you, Tony. I've got to say, if you're going to go to a neutral site, which has been one thought that I've seen in the media, if you're going to go to a neutral site and hole up there for a period of time, a month or something, do you test every day? I mean, if you've got enough tests for everybody, and we're not going to be at the front of the line, we're going to be with everybody else in the line on this testing. We're not frontline healthcare workers and everything else. So are the great tests available in enough bulk or whatever volume that we can actually get this done? But there's really, really smart people trying to advise us on this stuff, and we're trying to get there, not at the expense of anybody's health and safety.
It's Celtics managing partner and Governor Wick Grosbeck joining us on the Volkswagen Dealers Expert Hotline. Wick, do you believe the players would agree to a quarantine situation from what you understand from the Players Association?
I think my instinct just from being in the league 18 years, but I haven't asked any players this specifically, is would they agree to a quarantine? I think guys want to go play in general if it's safe. I don't think they want to do anything that would put – nobody wants to put them or anybody else at risk. But my gut would be – I'm not speaking for the players. My gut would be that people would rather finish the season than not. I'd be surprised if it wasn't the case. But I'm not speaking for them in any way.
Let me ask you personally. Would you enter the biosphere, or what we call the hamster cage, for the month, 2 months that it would take? Would you, you know, quarantine yourself from your family for the month or two it would take to finish the year?
Yeah, if there's enough testing, maybe we're all at the hotel, and then one person out of the family goes into the hamster cage or whatever. But I don't think I'm viewed as, despite my lofty title or what I think is a lofty title, I don't think I'm viewed as essential. I mean, it's the people that are probably last on the list of being essential at the game, but it'd be fun to be there.
Wick, I know we're hitting you over the head with this particular topic, but and I know you weren't on the calls with the president, but can you shed any light on what types of things might have been discussed or brought up with the president on those commissioner's calls?
No, Adam has not shared that in any depth with us. He just said they were cordial calls with, looking for positive steps forward. That's the extent, and, you know, I was not on those calls.
Wick, how do you feel about impacting the next season? In other words, if what it takes is losing games off the 2021 season to finish the 1920 season, are you willing to do that, or is there a feeling that you must preserve all 82 games in the full 2022 season or 2021 season?
Kind of thing. Yeah, we have not talked about that. That's the kind of thing we'll talk about in May, June, July. Extending this season further, but finishing it would mean maybe we shorten next season, or maybe we move it, you know, shorten it a little, but move it off a little bit later in the calendar, or have a few more. I remember after one lockout, work stoppage, we played triple headers, okay, back to back to back, to get back with the union's agreement to get back and finish the season. So it may be, though, that, I mean, I think it's all on the table over the next 2 years. First of all, we got to get out of this virus situation globally over the next 18 months, 2 years. We've got to play basketball if we can, way down the list, but we'd like to play basketball if we can over the next 2 years, as many games as we can that are entertaining and to people and safe. So it's all in the mix, but I think this season and next season are kind of both in the mix, both on the table, I would imagine.
Wick, have you gone back at all and thought about, you know, when it all, came to an end there on March 11th, March 12th, and Rudy Gobert, you know, being the guy, and he had played in your building the Friday before, and, you know, we know Marcus Smart, ended up getting positive. And just, I don't know exactly what my question is in there, but, you know, is something around that time. Is there any thought that Rudy Gobert got it while he was here because there was the outbreak with the Biogen folks, or, you know,
yeah.
I mean, just any thoughts about how that all went down? Because you were this team, the Celtics were involved in that whole thing there at that time.
And that's true. In fact, the night before the game with the Jazz, I think we hosted a corporate partner dinner with one of our corporate partners, and Marcus was the guest, and I was at the dinner, and I made a point of telling everybody, and other people were there too, but I'm like, look, we're just doing elbows. And it was, even at the time, this was like whatever day in March this was, the 5th or 6th or something. It's a little early to be doing just the elbows, but I'm like, we're just doing the elbows, guys. And there were like 20 of us at the dinner, and Marcus was there. And then he ended up later on testing positive, but nobody else, as far as I know, nobody else at the dinner tested positive. But it was sort of like, you realize how this thing can sneak up on you and how many thousands of people have actually been infected. So it's scary.
Wick, what kind of access or communication are you having with your players right now overall?
I am not one of the guys that texts them all the time anyway, or gets texts from them all the time. When it does happen, I really value it and think it's great, but I don't want to bug them. But they know they can reach out to me or anybody, Danny and so on, if anything's going on that they need help with. But so I've been in touch with a few, but it hasn't been any much more than normal. We're letting them. I know the basketball staff, though, is all over them and training staff. So I'm letting that go, and I'm sort of having a little hello every now and then with a few of the guys.
Have you called Tatum and said, you know, we'll send you a basketball, or, you know, let us come over and build you one of those Goliath rims, backboards in your driveway? Did you hear this thing about him not having touched a basketball or have shot in hoops? And can you address that?
The minute I read that, I was texting a few key people, and then, you know, there was an interview. He did an interview 2-3 days later. He's like, well, I've ordered a hoop. It's on the way. It'll be in the driveway. So I think that's been addressed. Also, there's ball. I think the first phase of our outreach was make sure everybody had fitness equipment in their house, everything that they needed. And that was all set up. And so it was like keeping in shape. And then I guess maybe basketball is the second part. But now they're all doing, my understanding is that they're all doing at-home ball handling drills and everything else in addition to fitness. And I think guys have hoops, and I'd be surprised if they didn't. I did read that Jimmy Butler was the only guy in the Heat that had hoops, and then he bought them for everybody else. You know, so this isn't just us. I think a lot of these guys live in apartments and they don't have basketball hoops, but we'll get there.
Wick, if the league were to come back the next handful of months, and with all the benefit of the time off, players like Kemba Walker, who have had time to heal up, he was dealing with a knee issue, would you feel maybe a little bit more confident about the Celtics' chances competing for a title this year as compared to if the shutdown never happened?
Hard to say, Murray. I mean, I wasn't feeling, I didn't think we had it in the bag. But obviously, we're in third place. But I'd really like to give these guys a chance. We're the youngest team, just about. I mean, we're in the lowest few teams in terms of age. So can we bounce back? Can we get in shape in time? Can you know, quicker almost? I mean, I would just love to be playing. I was texting with Wes Edens last night. It's like we should be, you know, pointing towards a series, you know, the conference finals. And I'm like, well, we're not quite there yet, Wes, but that'd be a lot of fun. Like, it's, I can't wait to get back if it's safe.
Okay, Wick, in closing, tell us about the vaccine program that you're associated with.
Oh, no. Well, I'm sorry. I already mentioned it. There are a lot of great people doing a lot of great work. There's a gene therapy vaccine that we're backing, and then there's a drug trial we're backing over at Mass General. They're giving people nitric oxide. It's in the clinical trials. And they're giving it to, you know, hundreds of patients, and they don't know if it's going to work or not. They feel it's probably safe. It's one of probably 1,000 trials that's going on around the world. So, I mean, there's things that can be done. I've been a medical investor for 20-plus years, and I believe that medicine will come and knock this thing down. We got to wait for it, but I think it will get there. So I'm trying to leave on an optimistic note here.
Wick, we want to thank you so much for taking the time to do this. We really appreciate the update. It's really very valuable to everybody. Thanks again.
Thanks, Wick.
Thank you, guys.
Okay, be well, be safe. Best to your family and all of that. Thanks again.